Dune is a film that continues to grow in stature as the years pass. Why do you think it has become such an undisputed cult classic?
Well, I think because it has great intrinsic qualities, which it always had. But unfortunately, at the time when it was released, it just wasn't quite the right time for all that. And I think David Lynch has such a wonderful visual imagination and skill. It was incredibly beautiful. And I think that stays constant, you know, the look of it and the feel of it is very, very unusual and very particular to David, who has a wonderful mind. And I think that's something that can't go out of fashion. Working for David was quite unlike working for anybody else. I mean, it is an experience in itself. He's meticulous, but you don't really know what's going on in his mind, of course, when you're working for him. He asks you to do things that don't really make much sense to you at the time, but when you see the finished result, you absolutely see why he asked you to do it. So you have to trust him to a large extent when he asks you to do something quite mad, that there is a point to it. I've always felt very confident in his taste and judgment, so I would do anything he asked me to do. We were talking about hair, makeup and costume. The costume was a given, that was there. But it was a very unusual costume because it was highly flammable, so I couldn't actually walk anywhere where I might go anywhere near anybody who was smoking. So I always had to walk with two people, one in front of me, one behind me, and one each side. So my activities during the day were very, very limited. We were mostly confined to leaning on a wall because I wasn't allowed to sit down either. And it was made out of the fabric that ballet dancers used to wear in the 19th century when they regularly used to go up in flames because they were standing too near the footlights. So that was my costume. And then they said, so what about your wig? And suddenly I heard myself saying, I don't think I should have hair at all. And David said, oh, I'd thought of that, but I didn't think you'd like it, maybe. I said, no, I had no idea what it would look like, but I said, no, I'd like to try it without hair. And that's how that look came about. And I think it was very successful. It worked really well.
So many iconic moments in the film, so many memorable scenes. I think particularly the box is a scene. Can you talk a little bit about filming that iconic moment in film history?
It was very arduous to do. It took weeks to do, and it was done in a small igloo. We were all crowded into this tiny space, and Kyle and I just sat there knee to knee looking at each other. And at the end of 3 weeks, because it was lit, we were very close to the lights as well, I realized when I took my bald cap off at the end, there was actually a bald line all through my hair where the wire of my headdress had gripped it, because the lamp above had burned itself into my headdress, which had translated into burning into the metal piece that attached itself to my head. So I had a totally bald trench all across the top of my head at the end of that scene. So it was quite tough to do.
Having been part of iconic original films, how you feel to see new versions of those same stories?
Well, I sometimes they work, but more often than not, they don't seem to work. I don't know why. Because they have more technical resources, more money. Oh, no one could have more money than David had. I mean, that was a very expensive picture. I wish them luck, but I don't know. Because, of course, it wasn't successful. You know, there were going to be five of them. We all had to sign our lives away, more or less. And then they said, no, we don't need your life. Thank you very much.